morning and welcome. My name is Tim Mowry, and I'm president of the Bethel Park Historical Society, and we welcome you today for the dedication of the school. At this time, I'd like to introduce Susan Dolinar to do the Pledge of Allegiance.
If everybody would stand, please. And I'd like to introduce Layton. It's going to help us with the Pledge of Allegiance, a future graduate in 2029. Okay. I pledge allegiance
to the flag of the United States of America and to the Republic to which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
And now the Bethel Park alma mater. If everybody would join in, please.
Ready, Susie? She said she wanted to sing, so. Oh, alma mater Bethel High, all hail to thee. We sing the praises, everyone, with love and loyalty. From atop of summit's brow, keep a watchful eye. We'll always love our colors true, our Bethel High. Well, that was...
You're lucky you didn't hear me sing, by the way. Yes, it was. Okay, today is a day for thank yous. There's been a lot of people involved in getting us to where we are today. First, I'd like to thank the Bethel Park School District and the municipality of Bethel Park. Back in 1996, they're the ones who donated or dedicated this property to the Bethel Park Historical Society. So I'd like to thank them. I would also like to thank all past members of the Bethel Park Historical Society that worked since 1996 till today to really preserve the history of the community and the history of this building. I would also like to thank the current 80-plus members of the Bethel Park Historical Society, and you'll see today when you come in a little bit of their work. For the last year, they've spent a lot of time and work and hard hours trying to get to the building where it is today. We're not finished. We're only partway there, but I think what we have is truly a diamond in the rough, and we're at the very beginning stages of what the building could be. Most of all, I would like to thank the Bethel Park community, the graduating classes, the business, and all the residents of the community, how they've rallied around this project and helped us, whether it's donating money for windows or pavers or dedication to the rooms, or it's donating information and history of the community, because that's one of the things we really want to do is preserve the history of this community. And it's just truly been amazing the outpouring of support that we've had from the community. When we started this plan about almost a year ago, I guess it was a year ago this month, a $1 million capital campaign through the help of fundraising, grants, in-kind donations. I'm happy to say that we have raised over $300,000. The good news, bad news, it's a lot of money, but there's a long way to go as you come in and see the building and see what we've really started to do as far as the renovations. Well, there's many members of the community or the Bethel Park Historical Society, and I'll probably get in trouble for saying this, by the way. So if I don't show up for work tomorrow, somebody here may be a culprit. But there's two people that I would like to acknowledge that were really very, very instrumental in getting us to where we are today. Their time, their dedication, it's just been amazing the work that they've done. It's Susan Dolinar and Bill Habether. I don't always like to single people out, but they truly have been the people that have been out there doing the work. We can't tell you everything they did, but really a lot of things they did. Yes. But it's truly been, they've been a great asset, as well as all the members of the community. Okay, at this time, I would like to introduce Bill Habether, and he'll give you a little history of the building and talk about the future and where we're going.
Thank you, Tim. Good morning and welcome, everybody. Tim charged me with giving you a history lesson, so I should say good morning, class, and welcome to school. As you may or may not know, this actually was two buildings. The first building was built in 1905, and the entrance was on Park Avenue, and it was known as Bethel Township High School. It was a three-room school. Back in 1917, the Congress enacted the Smith-Hughes Act, which basically said any school district that would be willing to teach vocational training, they would give you money. Bethel opted for that, and they built this entire addition basically from this doorway here over to the left, and it became known as the Bethel Vocational School. And if you look above my head in the concrete section, you faintly could see where it says Bethel Vocational School. In 1927, Bethel was growing, and they built a new elementary school, which was right behind us, the Park Avenue School. And in 1934, the two schools swapped classes, and this then became a grade school. And up until the 1960s, it was used as a grade school until the school district decided it was a white elephant and they no longer needed it. So they began to use it as a storage facility for unused desks and other items. And they also sort of used it as an overflow as they were building new elementary schools throughout the borough. By the 1970s, the school district wanted to get rid of the building. They actually had it on a demolition list. People got up in arms. A group of residents, spearheaded by Don Anderson, got together, had a petition signed, and they were able to save the building. In 1991, the Bethel Park Historical Society was chartered, and in 1996, the school district sold the building for the grand sum of $1 to the Bethel Park Historical Society, which isn't a great deal of money, but when you figure we're running a $1 million capital campaign to renovate it, it's, I guess we got a pretty good deal way back when. So that was 1996. Over the course of the next 20 years, it was rented out, and it was the Schoolhouse Arts Center. In 2016, as Tim mentioned, we started our financial campaign of $1 million. And thanks to State Representative John Marr, he kicked us off with a $140,000 grant from the Gaming and Economic Development Fund. We're hoping, John, that we get the grant this year and to be able to redo the roof, which is in dire need of being replaced. With the $140,000 we received last year, we're actually, the proceeds are being spent now. We're actually putting in heating and air conditioning for the first floor, which is desperately needed. As we go forward, during the course of the year, we did many fundraisers. In April, we were fortunate enough that Comcast chose us as their recipient for their annual Day of Caring. So we literally had 100 people come in and donate their time and effort. We filled up 2.5 dumpsters worth of more debris, if you can imagine, and we're still taking things out of the building as we undo prior changes to the building to return it back to its 1905 and 1917 footprint. In May, we were fortunate that Sherwin-Williams chose us as their charity of choice this year. They donated $20,000 worth of paint, supplies, and their employees. They spent 2 days with us, and they painted the entire interior of the building, which is about 12,000 square feet. In May, through all of our fundraising, our window campaign, we had gathered what we thought would be enough money to replace over 100 windows. So we went out for bid to see which company would be doing that for us. And we were so fortunate in that John and Maggie Schmutzer of Metropolitan Windows, and their son Justin are over there in the corner. John walked the project with me, and he said, you know, Bill, we are just so enamored with what you and the community are trying to do here that we want to be involved. So they went back, did their magic, and they substantially discounted the price of the not only the windows but the labor. So without their help, all these beautiful windows that you're now looking at would not have been possible. So thank you very much to Metropolitan Windows. Literally 2 days ago, we had a construction company remove the asphalt in front of the driveway, and as you can see, we're actually back down to the red slag, red dog, of what would have been here originally. Our next campaign that we're funding is Pave the Way, kind of like the community center. We're going to sell engraved bricks to be placed out in the front, and ideally we'd like to have the entire driveway done in reclaimed brick, which would actually be beautiful and just add to the beauty of the front of the facade. So in the my next part is what's happening for the future. We want to make this a cultural center for the community. We are establishing several museums within the building for the miners to honor the Coverdale and the Molliner mines, a military museum to honor our veterans. We have a classroom set up as a former classroom, so the kids get a chance to see what it would have looked like to come to school here 100 years ago. So as we proceed, we know we'll be doing many more fundraisers. We just hope that the community, who has really rallied around this project, continue to support us in all of our efforts. And as a side, if anybody wants to get involved with the Bethel Park Historical Society, annual memberships are $20, family memberships are $40, and you actually, with your membership card, get to go to the Heinz History Center, and we have a representative from the Heinz History Center who will be speaking shortly. So in conclusion, we just hope that everybody enjoys all the fruits of our hard work, and that we continue to make this building a true asset for the community. And with that, I thank you very much, and I'll turn it back over to Tim.
Thank you, Bill. Not only are we celebrating the opening of our building and the centennial of the addition, the Bethel Park Fire Department is also celebrating their 90th anniversary, and they're also holding an open house today. I'd like to bring up State Representative Rick Saccone, State Representative John Marr, Mike Smarr from Senator Rushenthaler's office, and Sue Means. They'd like to present a few proclamations. And I'd also like to invite the fire department up to receive these proclamations.
Thank you, folks. It really is an honor and a pleasure to be here today and honor this beautiful building and the efforts that have gone into restoring it, and also honor our fire department, which is top of the notch, first grade. We're so proud of the men and women that that protect us. And to celebrate their 90th birthday, we're here today. And I'd like to say that that's an accomplishment worthy of the recognition of the people of Pennsylvania. And as your state representative, and with my colleague John Marr, who has more of Bethel Park than I do and is a senior representative, I'm going to present this citation. I'm just going to read the last paragraph of it. There are a lot of whereases and wherefores in here, but I just want to read the last paragraph. And it says that from the beginning, it has provided effective fire service to the community, maintaining a commitment to upgrading its equipment and methods of operation. An extremely well-trained and disciplined team, the members of the Bethel Park Volunteer Fire Company are bound by the common goals of being well-prepared to preserve the lives and property of area residents and of safeguarding the well-being of their fellow citizens. Now, therefore, the House of Representatives of the Commonwealth of Pennsylvania salutes the Bethel Park Volunteer Fire Company on 90 years of steady growth and solid achievement, affirmatively states that its members reflect the highest traditions and values of emergency services, offers best wishes for continuing success as it moves toward further thresholds of excellence. It's signed by John Marr, myself, and the Speaker of the House, Mike Terzai, and has a beautiful representation of our State Assembly there. So congratulations to our fire department. I present that to you now.
It's an honor to be here today to recognize 90 years of service by the Bethel Park Volunteer Fire Company. As a resident of Bethel Park And my family has lived here for over 90 years. I have great appreciation for their service. And I want to recognize that the men and women of the fire company are a special breed. While most of us run and turn from danger, they run toward danger. They put their lives in danger to protect our lives and our property. And I would be amiss if I did not recognize the sacrifice of resources and time that not only they make, but their family makes. And when they rush toward danger, there are family members, wives, children, and parents on their knees in prayer, hoping for their safe return. And with great appreciation, I am so happy to be here today to read this proclamation from Allegheny County Council. Whereas Bethel Park Volunteer Fire Company was established in 1927 by 11 brave residents of Bethel to help protect their community from fires. Whereas in 1954, the Bethel Park Fire Company was responding to 158 calls a year and now responds to over 400 calls a year. Whereas the Bethel Park Volunteer Fire Company is a volunteer organization. No one gets paid. With over 70 members who participate in weekly training and drill programs, totaling over 2,140 man hours a year. Whereas the Bethel Park Fire Company relies on the generous donations of time and money from the Bethel Park residents and is responsible for the purchase and maintenance of valuable equipment. Whereas thanks to the highly trained, dedicated, and motivated volunteers, the Bethel Park Volunteer Fire Company has grown from one fire station to three fire stations covering 12 square miles. Whereas the department responds to both accidental and natural disasters, along with enforcing safety regulations and teaching educational programs on fire prevention, the average response time of the Bethel Park Volunteer Fire Company is less than 5 minutes. Whereas throughout its 90 years of service, the Bethel Park Fire Company has trained numerous Bethel Park firefighters and provided stability and safety to the community. Now, therefore, let it be resolved that Allegheny County Council does thereby congratulate the Bethel Park Volunteer Fire Company upon the momentous occasion of their 90th anniversary. We recognize and commend the Bethel Park Volunteer Fire Company for their bravery and their selfless service, protecting the lives and property of the citizens of Bethel Park for 90 years. Sponsored by Councilmember Sue Means, myself, and Councilman Sam DeMarco. Congratulations and thank you.
Hi, I'm Mike Smarr from Senator Reschenthaler's office. Our office wants to say congratulations to the Bethel Park Fire Department for 90 years of service, and we have a citation for you here. So, thank you.
Well, certainly not last but not least, this is my first official action on a certificate of commendation to the Bethel Park Fire Department on behalf of the Bethel Park Historical Society for its 90th year of service to the community. So we say thank you. Yes, and if after this is over, they're having an open house, if you'd also like to stop over. But thank you very much. Okay, at this time, I would like to bring back State Representative Saccone for an acknowledgement of the Bethel Park Historical Society.
Thank you all. Again, as we I just got finished touring this morning, this wonderful building, and although I didn't go to school here, and I know Sue Means did. I went to a building similar to this, and she told me that. That's true, right? You went to school here, right? I went to a school building similar to this, so as I was walking through it, it did bring back a lot of tremendous memories, and I'm so glad that we have the Historical Society to preserve these types of things for us. I am a big history buff and a historian, and I respect history, and I'm so glad that we're making the effort to bring this building back into the community, make it multi-purpose, make it useful, and restore the integrity of this building. So again, from the state, John Moore and I have prepared a letter of recognition, and I'll just read it. It's very short. It says, celebrating with you the rich history of the Schoolhouse Arts and History Center building for 100 years through its transitions from Bethel Vocational School to grade school to Bethel Park Historical Society, and now the Schoolhouse Arts and History Center. The schoolhouse has been a well-recognized historic landmark in the Bethel Park community, and we thank you from the people of Pennsylvania. And there's a citation here, and it's from both John Marr and myself. So congratulations to you all. Again, I'll present this to Tim Mowry. Thank you. Thank you.
Okay, at this time, I'd like to introduce our state representative, John Marr, and before he comes up, short of embarrassing him. But John was one of the first advocates of the group. As Bill had mentioned earlier, he was instrumental in getting us our first major grant to start the renovations, and that's going to pay for the heating and air conditioning. It's going to be installed on the first floor. But more importantly, he was the first one that purchased a window when the window campaign started. So I'd like to introduce State Representative John Moore.
Thank you, Tim. I'm not easily embarrassed, but I am just now. I wasn't expecting to speak, but I was just enjoying the moment with you. And think about this. Bethel Park, in the words volunteer, come together so easily and so regularly. When you look around our community, so much has been accomplished because people in the community step up. Our volunteer firemen, I salute you and thank you. But how many times have you traveled around town in the last year or so and noticed people working right here? And most of the time, those people are volunteers working on this building. And it makes my heart happy to represent Bethel Park because this is a town that truly does have its own heart and soul. And I'm just so proud to have a little part to play in all that. And I thank those who've taken the lead, Tim Mowry. Everybody's disappeared behind me. Nobody wants to get recognized. And this is another thing in Bethel Park. The people that do the hard work often shy from the attention. It's a great town. I'm privileged to be here today, and thanks for all that all of you have done.
Thank you. At this time, I'd like to introduce our county councilperson, Sue Means.
Hey, Tim, before you escape, you know, he gave accolades to Susie and Bill, but Tim is a force to contend with, and he is really one of the driving forces around saving this building. So thank you, Tim. Thank you, Tim. It is an honor to be here today, and as Representative Rick Saccone shared, I did attend this building in sixth grade. I was part of the bumper crop after World War II, and there were just too many sixth grade classrooms throughout the municipality, so I had the honor to go to school here. And my father also attended the school here when it was a junior high. Volunteerism is what makes America great. Again, as Representative Marr mentioned, there are people that see a need and rise to the attention. They come forward, step forward, and fill the need. This building represents our history. Our history keeps us grounded. Our history helps us remember and celebrate all those people who invested in our lives. The people who taught us, our parents, our friends, they keep us grounded. And they help us remember our values and our freedoms from where they come. My proclamation has a lot of the history right in the beginning. And I don't want to repeat because Bill did such a great job with the history. So I'm going to start down a few paragraphs into my proclamation. Whereas the residents of Bethel Park and the members of the Historical Society have dedicated countless hours and resources into the saving the building that has provided an education for many local students. Beyond preservation, the Historical Society wants to provide a history, a cultural center for the residents of Bethel Park that will include educational classes and a venue for meetings and tours. Now, therefore, let it be resolved that Allegheny County Council does hereby recognize the rebranded Schoolhouse Art History Center, home of the Bethel Park Historical Society, on the momentous occasion of its 100th anniversary of the addition made to the original building. The Bethel Park Historical Society and the Schoolhouse Arts History Center commitment to the community and its citizens serves as an inspiration to us all, and we offer our sincerest thanks to your dedication and the conservation of local history for the present and the future residents of Bethel Park. Sponsored by myself, members of County Council Sue Means and Sam DeMarco. Congratulations.
Thank you very much. Okay, at this time I would like to just acknowledge, and I know if some of the members are here, we have a certificates for some of our major donors that helped us at this point to renovate the building. Scott Anderson, the Bethel Park Community Foundation, Dan Duff, I think, is here. Earl and Gertrude Hollinshead. Earl and Sylvia Hollinshead. The William Knaus family, Georgianne, would you like to come up? The Mercer Ursini families, Bill will accept that on behalf. And the William Murdoch family, which are actually our first donor to help restore the original classroom. Okay, at this time we have a special presentation from the Bethel Fife and Drum.
Is Marty? She's not. Okay. Chris, if you can...
Okay. We have a special presentation today for another major donor to help restore one of our classrooms. And it's a donation of $10,000. And that's for a room that's going to be started hopefully sometime after the first of the year.
You see them, their proclamation. And we kind of had a feeling that we were going to get the check, so we quickly printed this up in the back room. So let me...
Okay, at this time I would like to bring up the Mayor of Bethel Park, Jack Allen. Would you like to say a few words?
Thank you, Tim. It was just actually a little bit over a year ago that we stood on the other side of the street and dedicated the fire department. And today, it's a great pleasure to be here to rededicate this schoolhouse. And I just wanted to mention that over the past year or so, every time we had a meeting, I think it was on a Saturday, Tim would be there in his jeans or whatever, because he can't stay. He has to go. So he was always here, and I want to recognize especially Tim, Susie, and Bill, the great job that they did, and what this building has become. So thank you very much.
Okay, we also like to introduce our magisterial judge, Ron Arnone.
Thank you. Good morning. What a wonderful day again it is in Bethel Park. So much has been said here today, and without being repetitive, I would just obviously like to acknowledge Tim and certainly Susie and Bill. What a great job, but so many others, and I know Tim would agree with that, all the people in the Historical Society, so many that had spent a lot of time here helping out to restore the building, and the business owners, and congratulations to the fire company as well on your anniversary. There are so many great things happening in Bethel Park, as Representative Marr and Saccone alluded to. And boy, I can tell you, it's a proud day to be here in Bethel Park and to be part of this. I would like to buy the first 10 bricks and contribute $1,000 to the and I hope many will follow suit in that and get with me to do that as well. I also want to let a little cat out of the bag. Our court, our whole operation has moved over the last week. We've been working on it for a long time, so I've been a little busy, but it's kind of a coming together of sorts with regard to the little brief announcement that I want to make. And these people don't know it. Skip Hornack had sent in a request to have our new Citizen of the Year be Bill Habether. And I want to announce today that Bill is going to be our Citizen of the Year. And we are going to do a special acknowledgement to Bill in the upcoming weeks at the court, and I'm sure there'll be a lot of recognition and good people there. But the reason why I wanted to mention Skip and him obviously rising up, Bill, is Skip is a guy, he's one of those people that Tim and so many have talked about that are the behind-the-scenes guy, but he does so many great things for the community and takes no acknowledgement, like the Police Veterans Memorial. He's up there almost once a week or twice a week fixing that up. And these are all these little people, big people, that do so many little things that make Bethel Park so great. And I want to acknowledge you too, Skip, and thank you for all you do. And Bill, congratulations on the first annual Citizen Award presentation. God bless you all. Thank you. Bethel Park is on top, and we're going to continue to work to be with the great leadership that we have in Tim and the mayor and so many others. God bless. Thank you.
Congratulations. We're going to be doing a special acknowledgement.
Okay, that was unexpected. Thank you very much. Getting back to the program, actually, Frank Stroker is here. Here he is. He's from the Pittsburgh History and Landmarks Foundation. And this is one of these prideful moments for me because 27 years ago, this building was actually designated as a historic landmark by the Pittsburgh History and Landmarks Foundation, but the plaque was never purchased. So one of the first things that we did was go out and purchase the plaque, and it's my extreme honor with Frank to unveil it, and it actually now just dovetails with the centennial of the addition of the building, so it couldn't be a better timing for that. So with that, Frank, thank you very much for coming out.
Thank you. And I'm going to let Bill do the unveiling, but I'd like to say that it's truly the commitment of everyone here that we are preserving our past to enrich our future. And I think that looks great, and I hope that everybody's enjoyed this. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Frank. I think, you know, it's a perfect place, and trying to decide where we actually were going to place the plaque, we knew it had to go on this side, because on this side, back in 1918, 1919, there was a plaque that's currently at the Bethel Park Library in the front. It was purchased by the residents of Bethel back then to honor the World War I veterans. So at some point in time, when we get a little additional money, we're going to have that plaque replicated and put back on the left side, and there was an eagle on top. So, but this is definitely a nice start. So thank you very much, Frank,
thank
for
you.
Coming out.
Thank you.
Okay, one of the other little surprises that we have today, back in April, we had finished one of the classrooms, actually right above this room, and we rented it out to a young artist named Ashley Gardner. And she was so excited to have this studio space. She said, she came to us and she said, is there something that I could do for you guys to honor the centennial, sort of the grand reopening? And she donated a painting. Unfortunately, she's at a showing outside of Pittsburgh today. She wasn't sure if she'd be back in time. But yesterday she presented us with the painting. And Tim, if we can do the honors. It's a representation of a 1934 image that we're lucky enough to have the photograph of. And so Ashley Gardner, after the ceremonies, you can go upstairs and check out her art. But thank you very much, Ashley. Sorry. And next, you know, part of being a historical society, you have to be in tune with what's happening in our community. And we're fortunate that Pittsburgh actually, for the past 53 years, has had a wonderful historical society who's done so much for the Pittsburgh area in preserving the architecture, the buildings, and the history of our community. So it's with pride that I also bring up Robert Stakely from the Heinz History Center. He just wants to make a few remarks.
Okay. Good morning, everyone. I feel a little out of place this morning, not because I have shorts. It's a beautiful day out here for October. But show of hands, is there anyone here from out of state? Okay, a few people. I thought maybe I was the one who came the furthest. I had to cross not one river, but two rivers, cross a bridge, and go through a tunnel to be here this morning. So where do you think I'm from? I'm from the North Hills, exactly. I didn't hear any boos. That's good. Good luck. I think that Bethel Park is kind of the equivalent of the suburban community that I live in, and that's Shaler Township, the Shaler Area School District, North Hills, and that's exactly where I'm from. But my name is Robert Stakely, and I'm an educator, and I also manage our History Center Affiliates Program. I'm lucky to be able to work with 450 sites across this tri-state area. And I know that preserving history is a fun and rewarding job, but it's not easy. Over the past few months, I had the luxury of just last afternoon, helping the Shaler North Hills Library celebrate their 75th anniversary. We opened a museum similar to this in the North Hills in North Allegheny School District. Unfortunately, we had to also help a museum close, and that museum was located in Mount Pleasant, PA. But with the team of individuals, I know that you and Bethel Park can do it. Being one of the last speakers here and hearing all the good words and efforts that have been put forth, I know that this team can do it. The World War II expression that you often hear and you see Rosie the Riveter when she flexes her arms, the saying is what? We can do it. Exactly. I knew from the first very moment when I met Bill and his team that he could do it. I never met a person that was so enthusiastic, so passionate about his local history. And this community should be so lucky to have an individual, a leader such as him. In fact, if he wasn't here or putting so much time and effort with the Bethel Park Historical Society, I would easily recruit him for my team of the team at the Heinz History Center. He's an awesome person, and I know that only good things can come in the near future. And that's really what history is all about. At the Heinz History Center and the museums and historical societies that we work with, it's about providing links to the past for understanding the present and for guidance of the future. And by a show of hands, do we have any individuals who work in the museum profession or museum community? Okay, one. Do we have any history teachers out here? I'm seeing if Mr. Dick Catano, who's a history teacher at Bethel Park, is here this evening. My point in doing that is that you don't have to be a museum professional. You don't have to be a teacher of history of any level to contribute to the success of this organization. In fact, if I were to poll you or kind of understand what your professions are, a judge, a lawyer, a police officer, a fireman, all that you do or all that we do as an individual, a family, a community, is based on history, correct? History is that common bond that brings us all together. And it's through history that helps us to, once again, understand our present and give us guidance for the future. And it's such immediacy as far as I coach my son's baseball team. And I teach history to those kids each and every time that we're together. No, I'm not a reenactor. I don't go in costume, dressed as George Washington, and teach those students or those players about the early history of Western Pennsylvania or the Whiskey Rebellion. But what I do tell them is history is all around us. Think about it. The street names, the intersections, the businesses. But it's as simple as analytics, which is a real part of the sport of whether it be football or baseball. I teach those kids three balls, no strikes. What should you do on the next pitch? I point to my batter and I go like this. History tells us to what? Take that pitch. Look for ball four. We're going to get on to first base. So history is something that may have happened a pitch or a second ago, but history can be something as this building that was built right around World War I and even further back than that. So once again, I am truly honored to be here as a representative of the Heinz History Center, and the Bethel Park Historical Society is one of our best affiliates. And I'm truly honored to be here this morning, this afternoon, and the History Center will continue to support the Bethel Park Historical Society and all of its future endeavors, because I know that Bill and his team have assembled a community of volunteers, and he has, and this organization has the resources to make this a reality moving forward, past, present, and future. I only see good things for the Bethel Park Historical Society. Thank you, and again, keep up the great work. Thank you.
Thank you very much. My last comment's going to be on the trolley. As you have seen, this is actually owned by the municipality of Bethel Park. They were kind enough to repaint it this time. We went back to its original colors, so it will be open today if you'd like to go through. Well, I'm going to end where I started, and I just want to say thank you to everybody for coming. Thank you for everybody that's participated in all our programs. And I'd like to, at this time, welcome everybody in to see our building. And the Schoolhouse Arts and History Center is now open. So thank you very much.